I'm not kidding. This woman is wrangling her peacock into the airport. Right now, wrangling a peacock in the airport.
It's emotional support.
Yep. That happens all the time. That just happened. What the hell, New York?
United Airlines denied an emotional support peacock from boarding a recent flight. In addition to perhaps hurting the peacock's pride, the move has renewed online debate about how to handle support animals in flight. The travel blog Live and Let's Fly first reported on the peacock's no-flight plight at Newark Liberty International Airport. The unidentified woman even offered to buy an extra ticket, but United still refused to take her bird under its wing. Perhaps there just wasn't enough room for the peacock to shake its ample tail feather. As a United spokesperson told Fox News, it didn't meet guidelines for several reasons. United told Fox it warned the human traveler in advance that her peacock was not free as a bird to fly. And this latest flap comes less than 2 weeks after Delta Airlines announced plans to crack down on passengers who pass off untrained household pets as service and support animals.
Delta is cracking down, issuing new rules for passengers with emotional support animals. People bringing pigs on flights. Even ducks and kangaroos. The airline reporting an 84% spike in animal incidents, including urination, defecation, and biting.
Often it's about the money, because one way to travel with a pet on some airlines can be up to $600. But if that animal is designated as an emotional support animal, it gets to come with you for free.
So experts say in recent years, more and more people are cheating the system, getting certified online for an emotional support pet without any proof. I tried it in the past.
What type of animal do you have? Dog.
Getting my ESA certification in just minutes.
And boom, there it is. Based on your responses, you are a good candidate for an emotional support animal. Great.
Then they email me this official letter from a real mental health professional.
Come on.
And before you know it, I'm flying with Rory. My producer, Lindsay, did it too. With a pig.
Pig on a plane.
But now, Delta's new rules, making it harder to pass your pet off as an ESA. You must provide the pet's ESA certification, proof of health, and a signed document saying your pet has been trained. You need to send the documents to Delta 48 hours ahead of your flight.
How will this help?
Hopefully by reducing fraud, but without putting a greater burden on people who really need emotional support animals.
Weeds out the bad ones, keeps the good ones able to do it.
That's what we're hoping.
Jeff Rawson, NBC News, New York.